Hello everyone, welcome to our first ever LiteSpeed Q&A video. Today we'll be looking at some of your questions about LiteSpeed Web Server hosting, licensing, and WebAdmin. Now let's get into it. Where can I find LiteSpeed Web Server hosting? LiteSpeed Web Server is offered by hosting companies worldwide and has one-click images available from cloud service providers. To find a hosting provider, visit the LiteSpeed website and click Partners. Scroll down to Hosting Providers and click More Partners. This will give you the full list of LiteSpeed partners, which you can filter by country, type of services provided, and cache solutions provided. All LiteSpeed partners offer licenses as part of a hosting package and offer support to their LiteSpeed customers. If you're looking for a more hands-on approach, LiteSpeed-powered images are available for all of the major cloud platforms. To find a cloud image, visit the LiteSpeed website and click Solutions. Scroll down to One Click in the Cloud and click the Learn More button. Here you can choose LiteSpeed-powered images from your preferred cloud platform. Click the image of your choice to be brought directly to the cloud platform's marketplace where you can make a purchase. What are the different types of LiteSpeed Web Server licenses? There are three categories of licenses for the enterprise version of LiteSpeed Web Server. Those are Free Starter, Site Owner, and Web Host. Each type of license has its own particular set of limits, and that's how you choose which license is right for your application. As the name implies, the Free Starter license is free. It includes one worker and has a one domain limit and a 2 GB of RAM limit. These limits are strictly enforced, so if you want to host more than a single domain, or your server has more than 2 GB of RAM, you'll need to choose a more robust license. The site owner licenses are meant for those who are hosting a small handful of sites. They too only come with one worker, but you can support up to 5 domains with the site owner license. There are 2 varieties of this license, one with an 8 GB of RAM limit, and one that allows unlimited RAM. The next set of licenses are the web host licenses. They are meant for those who are providing hosting services, and as such, there's no domain limit on these. And with the exception of the web host Lite license, which is limited to 8 GB of RAM, there's no RAM limit either. The web host licenses are distinguished by the number of workers assigned to each. The 5 web host licenses range from one worker up to a configurable number of workers. These 8 available licenses are configured to serve everyone from the low-end hobbyist with a single site to large hosting providers handling thousands of clients. So there's something for everybody. Knowing how many domains you need and how much RAM your server has should be enough to help you decide if you can make do with a free starter or a site owner license. If you know these will not be enough for your application, then you know you need a web host license. And from there, it's a matter of knowing how many workers you're going to need. This leads us to the next question. What are workers, and how do I know how many I need? A worker is a LiteSpeed process that is spawned to do general server tasks. This includes routing requests, SSL decryption and encryption, caching, rewriting, serving static content, and more. The more workers your license has, the more of these general tasks that can be performed at one time. As for how many you need, it may be a matter of trial and error. Leased monthly web host licenses may be upgraded or downgraded at any time. So choose a license using your best guess, and then try upgrading or downgrading to see if it affects your service noticeably. You'll be charged or credited the difference in the license cost for the remainder of the billing period. It's hard to know if you can get away with fewer workers without actually downgrading. However, there is a more scientific way to determine if you need more workers. And that takes us to our next question. How do I test if I need to upgrade to more workers? You can use the top command to reveal important information about how different processes are using server resources. Check the output for LiteSpeed Web Server's process, which is called LSHTTPD. There are 2 outputs that are particularly helpful here, %CPU and %WA. Generally, LiteSpeed Web Server's CPU usage is low. If that number starts climbing, especially while the overall server load is low, it can indicate that LiteSpeed is hitting a bottleneck and would benefit from an upgrade. High I/O weight can also be an indicator that LiteSpeed needs more worker process. If either of these indicators are very high, it's best to upgrade to the next license tier. What if I can't access my WebAdmin console? There are a few things that could cause your WebAdmin console page to be unavailable. The first thing is to check whether LiteSpeed Web Server is running. If it's not, you won't be able to access the WebAdmin console. Alternatively, do you have a firewall blocking port 7080? Or maybe you changed the WebAdmin port when you configure LiteSpeed Web Server. You can check the admin config file to see which port your WebAdmin is using. Lastly, if you're getting a 403 response, it's possible you've set the option to restrict access to the WebAdmin, and your own IP address is not on the allow list. You can edit the admin config to allow access from your IP. You can find more information and instructions for all of these troubleshooting steps in our documentation. The link to that is in the video description. And that's it for now. We hope you enjoyed this video and that you've learned something useful. Thank you for watching and for submitting your questions. If you think of anything else you'd like to ask us for the next Q&A video, you can leave your questions in the comments. And don't forget to check out our extensive documentation for anything you want to know, but don't want to ask. See you next time, everyone.